In this segment, we're going to take an example and solve it by using naive Gauss elimination method. So here you're given three equations. You're given three equations, three unknowns. The three unknowns are a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3. So we want to be able to find out what these three unknowns are. Now the first step which we're going to do is we're going to take the three equations, three unknowns which are given in the matrix form. We're going to write the augmented matrix. This is called the augmented matrix. This is going to make the explanation a little bit easier. And the difference between the matrix form or equation and the augmented matrix is that you're writing down your coefficient matrix here, and then you're writing your right inside vector right here. So you're not showing what the unknowns are, but it is presumed that you understand there are three rows and four columns, and the fourth column is your right inside vector. Now we have two steps in naive Gauss elimination. One is the forward elimination step, and the second is the back substitution steps. So let's go and see that how we can do these two steps. So let's concentrate on the forward elimination. So how many steps of forward elimination do we have to conduct? It's basically n minus 1, where n is the number of equations you have, or n is the number of rows and columns you have in the coefficient matrix. So in this case, we have three equations. You subtract one from here, you get two. So it's important to understand the number of steps of forward elimination is equal to n minus 1. In this case, since we have a 3x3 matrix for the coefficient matrix, or three equations, three unknowns, we'll have two steps of forward elimination. So we're going to concentrate on step one of forward elimination. What step one corresponds to is that you're going to take the first column and go below the first column, which is second row and third row, and you want to make these two elements to be zero. And how we're going to make these two elements to be zero is by using the first row and taking multiples of first row and subtracting it from the second row to be able to make this 64 to be zero and this 144 to be zero. So in order to make the second row first column to zero, I'm going to take a multiple of 64 divided by 25, which will be equal to 2.56. So I'm going to take the first row, multiply it by 2.56, and the element which I'm going to get here is 64, and that means that when I'm going to subtract this whole thing, which I get as a resulting multiple of the first row, then I'm going to get zero here. So here is the second row. I subtract the multiple of the first row. 64 minus 64 gives me zero, because that's what I was looking for. And then the resulting row is given here. Now what I want to do is I want to replace my second row by what I just obtained. And here's my zero. Now this is not the end of the first step of forward elimination, because I still have not made this to be zero. So let's go and see how I can make that to be zero. Now how I'm going to make that zero again is that I have 144 here. I need to make that zero, and this is my 25. So I'm going to make the multiple to be 144 divided by 25, which is 5.76. So I'm going to take the first row, multiply it by 5.76, and here I get my 144, because that's going to give me the zero which I was looking for. So that's the multiple of the first row. So this is my third row. I take the multiple of the first row, which I just found out, and I subtract the two, and this gives me zero, which I was looking for. And this will be the resulting row which I obtain. I'm going to replace my third row by whatever I get there. I have ended the first step of formulation, because I've gotten zeros below the first row in the first column. What is left now is the second step, because I have only two steps of formulation to conduct. And what I need to do is I need to look at the second row and make everything below the second row in the second column to be zero. In this case, it turns out to be I just have to make that to be zero. So the multiple will be minus 16.8 divided by minus 4.8, because I want to take this number, which is 3.5. So I'm going to take the second row, which I have, multiplied by 3.5, and I'll get this as my resulting answer there. I'm going to write down my third row. I'm going to subtract the multiple of the second row. And because this number is same as this number, when I subtract the two, I'm going to get zero. And that's what I was looking for. So the resulting third row which I obtained is going to be replacing my third row in the augmented matrix. And that's the end of the steps of all formula elimination, because I've been able to reduce the coefficient matrix, which is right here. The coefficient matrix is right here, but I've been able to reduce it to an upper triangular matrix, because I've got a zero here, a zero here, and a zero there. So that means that's the end of the forward elimination steps. So let's go and see that now how we can do back substitution to be able to find out what the unknowns are. So this was the augmented matrix which I obtained at the end of the forward elimination steps. I'm going to rewrite them back into the matrix form so that I can show you how to do the back substitution. If you look at the last equation right there, it can be written as 0.7A3 is equal to 0.7. So you only have one unknown in the last equation, and that gives you A sub 3 equal to 1. Now let's look at the second equation. The second equation is obtained from these elements, and this element is the right hand side. So you have minus 4.82 minus 1.5683 is equal to minus 96.2. However, we don't have two unknowns in this equation here. We only have one unknown because we just found out A sub 3. So we're going to take this to the right hand side, and this is what I'm going to get by writing down the equation in terms of A sub 2. I substitute the value of A sub 3, which is 1, and I get 19.72 as the answer for A sub 2. So again, I'm going to go backwards here. So I'm going to now look at the first equation, which is right there. Expand the first equation. It may seem that I have three unknowns, A sub 1, A sub 2, A sub 3 in this equation, but A sub 2 and A sub 3 have been found out from the previous steps of forward elimination of back substitution. And then I go and rewrite my equation in terms of A sub 1. A sub 2 is 19.72. A sub 3 is 1. I substitute those numbers and I get A sub 1 equal to 0.288. So what we have seen here is that we were given three equations, three unknowns in the matrix form, and we have been able to find the solution to these three equations, three unknowns by using the steps of forward elimination and back substitution. No matter how many rows and columns, or no matter how many equations somebody gives you, you should be able to use the Naive Gauss elimination method in most cases to be able to find out what the unknowns are. So if you're able to carry these steps of forward elimination, then you should be able to find the answer to any equation and unknowns which are given to you, if it has a unique solution, of course. And that's the end of this segment.